Hello 3D printing friends, today on the BV3D channel, we'll learn how to print directly to OctoPrint from Cura 5.3. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. This episode is sponsored by PCBWay. More on them in just a bit. Okay, so today we're going to see how to print directly to your OctoPrint-enabled printer from Cura 5.3. Now, the traditional way of printing to most consumer FDM 3D printers has a lot of steps. You slice a model with your favorite slicer, you get up from your computer, you go to your printer and remove the memory card, you come back to your computer with the memory card, you insert the memory card into a card reader on the computer, you save the G-code file from your slicer to the memory card, you eject the memory card, you take the memory card out of the computer, you get up from your computer, you go to your printer and insert the memory card, then you select the file from the on-screen list and you start printing. That's like 12 steps. Printing with OctoPrint cuts the number of steps in half. You slice a model with your favorite slicer, you save the resulting G-code file to your computer, you open a web browser to your OctoPrint instance, you drag the G-code file into the browser to upload it to OctoPrint, you select the file from the file list in OctoPrint and start printing. And that's only 6 steps. But you can streamline this even further and send your sliced file directly to OctoPrint from Cura and have it start printing automatically. Like, it's literally just slice and print and okay. So how can you get the whole printing process down to just 3 steps? I'll show you right after this. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay is known for making low-cost, high-quality printed circuit boards, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and even injection molding. They sent me a few samples, and I gotta say, these circuit board rulers and coasters are freaking amazing. And the clear resin prints of the PCBWay logo, these are 100% crystal clear. So whether you need PCBs, machining services, or even something printed in a specialty material your printer can't handle, PCBWay can do that for you. Check them out at PCBWay.com. Okay, so to get the printing process down to slice and print and okay, I'm taking for granted that you already have OctoPrint installed on a Raspberry Pi or something similar, and you've got your printer added to Cura so you can slice models for it. There's a video about how to set up OctoPrint linked in the description, so you can watch that one if you need to. Adding a printer in Cura is as easy as using Cura's Add Printer Wizard. Here, I'm adding a Creality Ender 3 V2. But the critical component that makes the magic happen is a Cura plugin named OctoPrint Connection by developer Field of View. To install this, click the Marketplace button at the top right corner of the Cura window. Search for OctoPrint. Locate the OctoPrint Connection plugin made by Field of View, then click its Install button. Read and accept the license agreement, and then the plugin will be installed. Then you'll need to quit Cura and open it again so that Cura loads the plugin. Next, we need to configure the plugin for our OctoPrint Connected printer. Make sure the printer is the active printer in Cura. Then click the printer drop-down menu and select Manage Printers. Click the Connect OctoPrint button. This is where we tell Cura which OctoPrint instance belongs to this printer. You can select your OctoPrint instance from the list, or you can click the Add button to add it manually. My personal experience is that manually adding the OctoPrint instance by specifying its .local network name works the most reliably for me, particularly when it comes to being able to see the webcam in Cura's monitor view. We'll need an API key from OctoPrint, and we can request one by clicking the Request button. This will take us to our OctoPrint instance's webpage, and then we can allow the API request. After clicking the Allow button, switch back to Cura, and you'll see the API key is filled in along with your OctoPrint username. I recommend checking the Confirm Print Job Options Before Sending checkbox. This gives you the opportunity to change the name of the file that will be sent to OctoPrint and also allows you to change whether you want to have the print start as soon as OctoPrint receives it. Then, click the Connect button to finish connecting Cura to OctoPrint. Finally, close the Connect to OctoPrint window and close Cura's Preferences window. With an STL file loaded in Cura, it's time for the just three steps printing process. Ready? Step 1, click the slice button to slice the model. Step 2, click the Print with OctoPrint button to send the file to OctoPrint. You can adjust the file name if you like or leave it as is. Step 3, the Print automatically checkbox is already checked, so click the OK button to send the job to OctoPrint and start printing. And that's it, just three steps. Cura will switch to the monitor view and show you the view from OctoPrint's webcam if you have one connected. It will also show you the temperature of the nozzle and the bed, and it'll show you a progress bar so you can see how far along the print is. On the macOS version of Cura, I noticed an issue with the plugin. It won't show the webcam view or the controls unless you have more than one printer configured to use the plugin. There has to be at least one other printer set up because for some reason, the monitor view only starts working when you switch it from one printer to another. Then just switch back to the printer you want to watch. This is actually pretty minor though because you still have full monitoring and control of the printer just by connecting to your OctoPrint instance with a web browser. So that's how to print from Cura to OctoPrint in just three steps. It's super easy to do and also super convenient. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, please give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss future videos. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this episode. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.